Hey everyone, today I want to go through one of the most useful features in Excel, which is the freeze pane feature. In the example on the screen, I've actually frozen multiple rows and multiple columns, which allows me to navigate through this data set very easily. You can see here my headings are in row 4, so I've frozen everything above row 4. Also, I want to keep the first and last names visible, so I've frozen columns A and B, and you can scroll back and forth and keep those columns available. So I'm going to go back to my original data set, show you how to do some basic freeze panes, and also show you how to freeze multiple panes, multiple rows, and multiple columns. Okay, so let's go back to the original data. And just to let you know, I do go through these videos very quickly just to keep them short. So if you need to, just pause or rewind. Now if I scroll through this data, left and right, up and down, you can see that the headings and the columns aren't frozen anymore. It makes it very hard to see what this data represents. So the first thing I want to do is freeze these top headings. So to do this, I'm going up to the ribbon, to the View tab, and under there, there's a section for freeze panes. There's three options. I'm going to select the second one, which is freeze the top row. Very simply, it has frozen the top row, makes it easier to navigate. But if you remember, I actually had an extra couple of rows in there. And I wanted to freeze the first four rows, not just the first one. So we'll go back up to this freeze pane and unfreeze. And to freeze the top four, all I need to do is highlight the very next row, which is row 5. I've highlighted the whole column or whole row. I'll go back up to the freeze panes. Instead of freeze the top row, I'm just going to freeze panes. And now you can see the first four rows have been frozen. Very similar to rows, if you want to freeze the columns, you have the option to freeze that first column, but we want to freeze the first two columns. So I'll unfreeze the panes to start again. And to do this, all you have to do is highlight column C, the very next column, go back up to freeze panes, and select that first option, freeze panes again. And now you've frozen the first two columns. But unfortunately, when I scroll down, the headings or the first four rows aren't frozen anymore. So the ultimate goal is to freeze the first four rows and the first two columns. So I'll show you how to do this. Before I do, if you could subscribe, you like what you see, that'd be great, or click that like button. So firstly, I'm going to go back up to that freeze panes and unfreeze again to start from scratch. And I'm just going to find that point, that exact point where I want to freeze the panes or freeze the rows and the columns. And that is in cell C5. So that'll freeze all the rows above 5 and all the columns left of C. You go back up to that freeze pane, select the down arrow, and select the freeze panes again. And as you can see, it's frozen the top four rows and the first two columns. Really easy, very handy once you get used to it. Hope this helped. See you next time.